Cancel culture rearing its ugly head again, but thankfully more people are fighting back this time. The latest example, the White House attempting to cancel the Atlanta Braves on the same day that President Biden hosted them at the White House to celebrate their World Series championship. Critics say the name of the team is racist and offensive to Native Americans, and the liberal mob has been demanding that they change it. Here's the White House.
We believe that it's important to have this conversation. And Native American and Indigenous voices, they should be at the center of this conversation. That is something that the president believes, that's something that this administration believes.
Cancel culture, not new. And legendary TV personality Sharon Osbourne knows a thing or two about it. She's taking the fight to the liberal mob in her new four-part series, Sharon Osbourne to Hell and Back, available now on Fox Nation. It documents the cancel culture firestorm that led to her departure from CBS opinion show The Talk. Osbourne was accused of being racist because she defended her friend, Piers Morgan's public criticism of Meghan Markle, and was later ambushed on the show. Take a look.
I was this lamb that was slaughtered that morning, and CBS denied responsibility on the news, and that's because they're...
You can get ganged up on live television, and when you go to defend yourself against accusations, you get fired for creating a hostile work environment. This is the world we live in today.
Sharon, welcome to The Five.
Thank you.
Is that still kind of upsetting to you when you watch that, what happened?
Not anymore, because I had 8 months of therapy, so I think I'm over it now.
Just 8 months.
Which wow. They didn't pay for, by the way.
Did you like to use Cobra and extend your health care, or no? You had to pay off.
Pay out
of your pocket. So wrong.
What was that like with people you worked with, executives you knew, really kind of stabbed you in the back and kind of set you up? How'd that make you feel?
Angry. I was pissed off and angry and at the same time hurt with my co-host, because especially one of the ladies I thought was a friend of mine. I mm-hmm. sat next to her for 10 and a half years and wow. I thought she was my friend.
You know, the amazing part of it is that you were in the crosshairs at CBS when it wasn't your fight. You were simply saying that Piers Morgan had the right to
freedom
express his opinion.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden you were called out.
Because they said he was a racist. But then I said, where? What has he written? What has he ever said that's racist? And they couldn't come up with anything. And their excuse was because Meghan Markle was a woman of color, he must be a racist to say she was lying. Only a racist would do that.
And what about the underlying issue that he says she was lying about? What was it, that she was married before?
There were 17 comments that she made that were all proven true later. And so it was, I was sticking up for my friend,
yeah.
who is a journalist. He has freedom of speech, as we all do. And to criticize somebody, fine, you're entitled to do that, but because she was a lady of color, then that makes you racist.
I think you're the only one that's ever stuck up for Piers Morgan, so congratulations.
I was wondering if looking back, if in the first 24 hours or even in your initial feelings or response, if you had to do it over again, if you had to go through it again, mm-hmm. would you react differently? Would
yes.
you have advice for people who are worried
oh, yeah.
that this might happen to them?
Yeah, I would have absolutely.
And Jesse, I'm speaking about him.
I'm going to write this down. Yeah, yeah. Speak slowly so I can take
notes. Yeah, I'll give you the notes. Okay, number one, I would have looked into the camera and I would have said, this was never rehearsed. This was not the show I was told I was going to do this morning. You are setting me up and I'm now leaving. Mm-hmm. But my head was like, I was in like, what's going on here? What's going on? And I was shocked. And then the more you try and defend yourself, the worse you look.
Interesting.
It would be like if Ainsley and Ducey just sandbagged you one morning.
Which is called Wednesday. Sharon, here's the thing. Do you believe have you done any investigating to see if it came from management? Because obviously you think it was orchestrated and they wanted to get you out. And yet you were invaluable to the show. Anyone who watched the show, you were the hinge of the show. So it was going to hurt the show to get you out. but it was important to get you out. How do both worlds meet?
Well, I was told by our showrunners, the show was run by two ladies, and I was told by both of them that morning, the woman who runs programming, she runs daytime and evening program at CBS, told them to do this to me.
Wow.
Oof. I mean, have you thought about taking action against them or just forget? Obviously, you turn the page, you're better off.
Do you know what the situation is? Do I want to spend 2 or 3 years of my life mm-hmm. fighting this? Because, you know, Judge, that's mm-hmm. how long it would have taken. Do I want to lay out the expense? No. And that's why I did this documentary. Mm-hmm. And I did it, too, because I didn't want it to be the end of my career. Because how dare they tell me when it's the end of my career?
Right.
And that's what they basically did in this country.
You have very close family members, and I'm curious if you have thoughts about if this is going to happen to somebody like Jesse, or me, or anybody, you know, any of us.
I think a lot of, what about the judge?
You know, why are we picking on Jesse?
Why are we picking on Jesse? Because it's called Tuesday.
Okay.
But I just wonder if there's a way for family members to support somebody who is going through this, even if it's not public like this, it could just be in a small town and it happens to somebody and their loved ones don't know how to react or how to support them. Was there something that happened in your family that helped you get through it?
Love. They would support me. They would tell me that, you know, this will pass. You're better than them. You're a genuine friend to people. They're mm-hmm. not genuine. And constantly my family were telling me that. And they were saying, you have a home to come back to every night where you're loved. Most of the people on that panel
isn't that
don't.
Interesting.
Yeah, I have a feeling if I got canceled, my mom would say, you know what, Jesse,
you deserved it coming.
Hi, everyone, I'm Brian Kilmeade. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to click to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page. This is the only way that I know for sure that you're not going to miss any great commentary, any great news bites, any great interviews coming your way on Fox. You can get it all here on YouTube. So subscribe right now.